So my next question is, we are living in the age of transparency. So basically, transparency is one of the values of this new century. Brazil has just passed its freedom of information law, which comes actually late. What do you think is the role of transparency for all that? Does it help improve the problems we are dealing with at Rio Plus 20? Or do we need the people in the middle so that they can actually know what to do with so much information that comes out of transparency?
I think it absolutely does matter. I mean, democracy is about representing your people, and if there's layers between you and the people, there's less communication there. So what social networks do is give us a direct channel to people to say, you know, we're not happy about something, or we think, you know, something should be done differently. So I think social media absolutely has created a more transparent society. And I think, you know, while there's obviously, on an individual level, that does create problems with privacy, right? Because we're so transparent that everyone knows everything about us all the time. But on the whole, I think it's fundamentally a good thing because it keeps people honest, and there's more of a feedback loop for individuals to get involved.
Mm-hmm. And for me, the most important is that you give voice to everyone. Just to make an example that I think it's good, how do I deal with it and how can I try to inspire people? I think, okay, it's very important, the document that you're going to have here after Rio Plus 20 and all the chief of states that are going to be here. But for me, the most important thing that is happening, that everybody's connected, all the NGOs, all the people discussing how the world will be in the mm-hmm. next 20 years or 100 years. And sometimes I think we think too big and forget to think about small things that happen day by day. Just to bring one example, that 2 weeks ago I reached the history of a woman in Espírito Santo, Dona Ercília, that mm-hmm. I reached her through the social networks. And can you put the picture of her, if you don't mind? I have yes, this is her house. Her house is in Nova Aldeia. This is 20 minutes from Vitória, Espírito Santo. And she arrives in from Minas Gerais in Espírito Santo 10 years ago, 2002. So we are talking about this century. And she arrived with two kids, his husband, right. Her husband, and just 20 packages of sugar. And no money, zero money. And she starts, she didn't know how to... Como é que fala analfabeto?
Illiterate.
Thank you. and she starts living about taking out garbage from the beaches. And one day she found two books on the beach. And there's another picture with the whole family. And she decided that she need to learn how to read that books. And now, 8 years after that, she passed to the university, the Federal University of Espírito Santo, and she will be in the next years a como fala restauradora. This is a hard question, huh?
Restorer.
Maybe. So.
Maybe.
Isso está ridículo. Meu inglês está péssimo. My English is terrible, but anyway. So what I'm trying to say that sometimes we are thinking too big, and the book that you throw away or give connection to people by internet can really change life, like Ercília, that now she's part of the society and not she's living only about taking out trash off the beaches. And I think this kind of things that touch me, that can inspire people all over.
Yeah, that's great. We got a question from Twitter. The question says, how can we use social media to actually continue the conversations that are happening here at Rio Plus 20? So
I think what's really key is, you know, when you're using social media, is to have some kind of common, I mean, it's very easy for tweets to get lost, or for, you know, if you're posting individually on Facebook or whatever, for it to get lost. I think there needs to be some kind of organizing function. Like, for instance, we have the Rio Plus Social hashtag. I'm sure, you know, Facebook groups will form and that people will create lasting hashtags that they keep using over time, because it's really about everyone having a way to coalesce and come around as a group versus, you know, everyone just putting out their tweets out there and them getting lost. So I think definitely like organization, groups, hashtags, like keeping all the conversation in one place.
Mm-hmm. I agree. I think the people, we are in a room with 500 people, but millions are connected and they feel that they're a part of it and they can give their opinion, good and bad, and make the discussion go over this 25 minutes that we have here.
Sounds good. I have a very specific question for Luciano, which is, what do you think is the role of Brazil globally in, for instance, what are the expectations regarding the role of Brazil for development, for sustainability? Do you think our country can play a role in the global scenario in these discussions?
Yes, I do, but I think we have lots of work to do here in Brazil first. Everybody is the big target in Brazil now is the middle class. And in Brazil, to be middle, the class have to get much better. I think we have lots of homework to do here. We are talking about Rio, São Paulo, but when you travel around Brazil and you go like to Pará, that I saw the picture over there a few minutes ago, we have a big step between the rich and the poor, and we have to make this balance better. We have to work hard inside Brazil, and this will allowed Brazil to be in the world scenario with much more strong power.
Sounds good. And I have one for you, Pete. A lot of the debate about sustainability is also about innovation. So people think that, for instance, research about energy efficiency or genetic engineering and so on can actually help to build a more sustainable society.